the morning to you. As you can tell by my bad accent and green shirt, we're going to be talking about all things March. So sit down, pour yourself something to drink, get comfortable and all that, and let's chit-chat. So I am drinking some sweet tea because it doesn't get any more southern than that, honey. And my mug of the month is actually my glass of the month. And this is from my last trip to Walt Disney World, which I took last month. You heard all about it in last month's chit chat. But this says Adventureland because it makes me think of my dad for two reasons. First of all, my very first Walt Disney World trip was with him. He took me, my sister. This reminds me of him. So I did that. And also, if I had to pick one of the top five words, if you said describe your dad in five words, adventurous would absolutely come to mind. He was so funny, so up for adventure, and was constantly exploring. He loved to search for arrowheads, and in fact, I shared that in my December chit chat. There's a little snippet of a video of him in there. But anyway, so this is for him because we're going to be talking primarily about him because my March was awful, and I'm saying that to be straight up and honest. The good news is that it feels like it flew by because I feel like I was in a daze for at least half of the month. Yeah, my March was awful. So the last time I talked to you on Chit Chat, I talked about my dad was diagnosed with terminal cancer. He had 6 months to live, and I talked to him on the phone and I said, I'll be there for a week. You know, I'll help take care of you. And it was absolutely fine. I showed up and I walked in, and the man that was there in the bed was unresponsive, and he looked kind of like my dad, but it wasn't my daddy, you know? It was absolutely bizarre. I had just talked to him on the phone. I just started to wrap my mind around the fact that I had 6 months, and y'all, within 2 hours, he was gone. And none of this was like the movies, which that sounds silly to say, but I haven't lost a family member, minus my beloved Granny Sugar 3 years ago. And, you know, she was 96, so she'd been sick and we knew she was going to pass away. But, you know, I just have no frame of reference for this. So I thought he would wake up when I showed up. He didn't. I thought he would take one breath and pass away, and it wasn't like that either. It was just a crazy, crazy experience, and it was awful. And it's something I never want to have to experience ever again. And I've just been like this whirlwind of emotions. And I don't know how much to talk about it with you guys, because I don't want to just go on and on and on. But I will be talking about it on the blog. Like I said, I'm going to do a post after he's been gone for 1 month. I'll talk to you about it then, just to give you like emotionally checking in. And then I'll do his like celebration of his life. But he will be absolutely missed. I cannot believe he's gone. There's sometimes where I'll be absolutely fine with it. Like now I'm talking to you guys and I'm, you know, like focused on the good things. And then there'll be sometimes where I just completely get so upset. And it just hits me like it's the first time. I'm like, oh my gosh, he's gone. You know, I don't have a daddy anymore. It's a crazy feeling. But two things. I'm absolutely thankful for the time that I had with him, and I'm thankful for you guys. I've told you before, I'm extremely private. I don't tell anybody anything. And to reveal that I needed your hope and prayers and support was a hard decision to make and to do. So I'm glad I did that, because y'all have been so amazing. Sometimes I feel like I work so freaking hard on my blog, on this YouTube, and I feel like it's a stop and drop, you know, where people just come by, which I'm thankful for, and then they leave a comment, you know, check out my channel or love your blog, want to follow? No, I don't. And it sucks because I worked so hard on this, and I'm like, well, these people don't care. But I'm glad I just decided to share this with everybody and ask for your support, because y'all have been amazing. I've thanked you on all of my channels that I have to thank you, as in social media, my blog, Instagram, everything. And I wanted to thank you here. So thank you for your prayers, your support, everything that you've done, the cards I've received in the mail. You guys mean so much. Even just a smiley face on a text message, it means the world, and it's encouraging, and I appreciate the encouragement. And if there's one thing I've learned from this, is that there is something to be happy about in every single day. You can find, no matter what struggle you're going through, there's something to be happy about. So with that being said, I'll talk about the rest of the month. I still have a cold that I got while I was visiting back home and all of that. And the worst thing of all, Charlie got attacked by another dog. I think I'm up to my limit for pain and sadness for the year, don't y'all think? I can like cash out and be like, okay, I'm good for a good 5 years, thank you. But yeah, it was awful. He ended up being attacked for no dang reason by a big dog that he knew. They were both on their leash, and she heard him and, you know, threw him, and the impact of the throw, which we're guessing was about 10 feet, ended up knocking his top teeth out. He has one little tooth left, a little snaggle tooth, and I'll have him at the end of the video, but he is miraculously okay now. Just the one tooth in the back. He can still eat and chew with his back teeth. He's fine, but it was really, really sad to say the least. And, you know, you think your heart can't take anymore, and then that you're not given more than you can handle. But gosh, y'all, I'm done. But, there's something to be happy about, I promise you. March had a lot of celebrations. I had a lot of birthdays in my family in March. I have my step-grandmother, one of my cousins, my mommy, happy birthday, mommy. Her sister, my Aunt Cindy, hey, Aunt Cindy. They had birthdays. My grandmother, my dad's mom, she just had a birthday. And one of the best things about March is that I finally got to meet my baby, brand new niece, Emmalynn. Princess Emmalynn. What did you guys do for St. Patrick's Day? Did you do anything? I didn't do anything but paint my nails. That was it. I was just not in the mood to celebrate this year. I'm having a hard time sleeping. It started off to where I just cannot fall asleep, where I'm just freaking wide awake. And now I'm getting better at falling asleep, but I can't stay asleep. I just wake up all during the night for hours and hours and hours. So if I look crazy, I think I say that every video. So if I look bad, if I look crazy, yeah, if I look crazy, it's just a couple of hours of sleep here. I have been using some beauty products, though, to help with that, some night creams and things. So I wanted to give a toast to my dad, and I will absolutely see you and sugar again one day. Cheers. Speaking of the month, since that's what this video is about, I'd love to share with you some of my favorite blog posts of the month. And my DIY of the month is going to be my tinted lip balm. This is such a good idea, y'all. If you have lipsticks that are too bright or too dark, if you want to make a gift for somebody, or if you're somebody that you don't like lipsticks, you don't like lip glosses, but you want just like a flush of color, you need to make this. It is so easy. Two ingredients, like 5 minutes of your time, and you can have it. The second post of the month that I wanted to mention would be my little hidden gems at the drugstore. So these are drugstore exclusive buys. No, I'm not talking about a Revlon lipstick. I'm talking about stuff that you can only find at the drugstore, maybe on Amazon. I don't know, depending on where you live. But these are some awesome, awesome items that I think you guys would really like and that you need to check that out. And the last post of the month, 6 beauty tools that you should be cleaning. Yeah, you know, to clean your brushes, your sponges, blah, blah, blah. But what about these other things? Check out the blog to find out what I'm talking about. Every month I do a just a little something challenge. Have y'all been doing these? I started this in January of this year, and essentially what I do is I pick one small little goal, because small changes can lead to a big difference. I picked for March to be present, because I am the cell phone girl. Gotta like that Instagram photo, gotta check that email, blah, blah, blah. And I really force myself to just be present, be in the moment. I can absolutely say I did that this month. Unfortunately, under horrible, sad circumstances, but I did it. And my just a little something challenge for this month, for April, the upcoming month, excuse me, is going to be to make one healthy choice a day, whether that's something that I eat, that I drink, that I do exercise-wise, something for my mental health, since I've just been, you know, dealing with a lot lately. One little healthy choice a day. So I hope you participate. If you participated in March's just a little something, let me know what your results were. And you don't have to do the same challenge that I do. Do what you want. Do what's going to work for you. Is it to walk more, to drink more water? What's one just a little something that you can do? And let me know what your results were. Let me know what you're going to do for April. I would love to hear it. Use the hashtag below so I can find you on social media. I'm going to be doing like a weekly reminder on Twitter. I'm at LCsYOU, same as my email, and we'll be able to keep up with it that way. I can't wait to see your results. Cheers. Something else I like to do would be to share products that I love and that I didn't love, but I feel like this video has gone on long enough, so I'm just going to skip straight to the Ipsy bag, and I'll leave my code below if you want to join Ipsy. And this month, you can see the floral print. It makes me think of summer, but I thought it was so cute, and it's blue on the other side. Some of the bags are kind of, but this one I liked. And inside, this is what I have. The first one is the Purelease Pure Delicate Gentle Soy Milk Cleanser and Makeup Remover. So you use this on your dampened skin to help clean it, and it is very, very gentle. I've used lots and lots of these products before. I've received them in different bags over the years and boxes, and it has blue lotus, white tea, soy protein, sea silk, and lupine peptides. Peptides are great if you are looking for firming of skin, which, honey, I am. So it's a 4-in-1. It washes away everything, great for all skin types. It's been fine so far. I'm not gonna say this is the best makeup cleanser in the world, but if you're looking for something gentle, I really do like it. Along the same lines, I have from Leoni.com. It's like Leoni Echo. This is a 3-in-1. It's a toner, serum, and moisturizer. I would say that this is just a light moisturizer. I don't really get the toner or the serum aspect of it. I just say it's a light moisturizer, so it's not bad. No big deal on that one. Easy to put on at night since it's one step. Will be great for travel. I have the Boo Boo Concealer. This is just a thick concealer, which is great for when I'm working on somebody and want to hide age spots, or even on myself, you know, whatever. Anything that you want to hide, but it is thick so it can cake up on you. So that's something to keep in mind. I actually have purchased this before, either from Amazon or friendsbeauty.com. It's in a haul somewhere, but yeah, I like it. From Vintage by Jessica something, it's already worn off. I have this beautiful illuminating face highlighter in crystal pink. How gorgeous is this? I have it on my lids today, but you can use this all over the body and all over the body, yeah, sure, your cheeks as a highlighter, and it is really, really pretty. Finally, what I have on my lips is this NYX Butter Lipstick, and this is in the shade Hunk. And I know what you're thinking. Look at this. It is so dark. There's no way that that's going to ever work on me, but it's what I have on. You can make this as intense as you would like. You can do just a quick little dab, rub it in with your finger, and you have a pretty color. So don't judge a lipstick by its cover. And one thing I can say, being a beauty blogger, I try to encourage that all the time with my readers. Don't think that's not going to work for you, because it absolutely could. So I've got like these just kind of like popsicle just bitten lips. I did a post on ways to get just bitten lips in case you need more ideas for this. But yeah, I like it. You're not going to get as much. It's very pigmented, but you're not going to get as much lasting time since it's not a matte lipstick, but it's not so moisturizing. I like the bag. So that's my March chit chat. I hope you guys are having a wonderful month, and I hope that April is even better. Here is the man of the hour, my wonder pup, Charlie. Do you say hi? I think that's all we're going to get out of him. But he's okay. He was just sleeping on the couch, and he doesn't like it when I put him in videos. So here he is, adorable. And he just has one tooth left up top. So I swear he's happy. But anyway, have a great day. Be safe. Behave and be well. Lavelle. Bye. And I'm going to juggle them for you. Are you ready? Here we go. Here we go. Ooh.